that women make up 50% of the world, right? It's a good half and half, just about. I mean, we wouldn't really be here without women. But for some reason, when it comes to these industries, there's always this weird gender, thing. For some reason, because of its history, because of what's entrenched in it, like it has been for many years. And I also think that it's a boys' club, and it has been for many years.
I feel like the movie industry is so male dominated in the messages it promotes. It's the male message. The male is always the hero. The male is always the stronger guy. You either need to push that same message or to get a new message.
Now, I will say it is very saddening and disheartening to know that women make up such a small portion of this, and I definitely don't understand that. I don't understand why.
First and foremost, I want to say I am psyched that we are even having this conversation. I'm gutted that it's taken until 2018 to have the conversation about women and how they're portrayed in the media. That's...
I did not know that this was an issue until this morning.
As creators, what do we do about it? To me, that's fascinating. To think that we all actually have the ability to do something about something that large.
It's something that I've long noticed that, you know, they're... The way films portray women as characters is often, I don't know, it's one of those situations where, you know, you have to ask yourself, is art imitating life, or is life imitating art? Or is art influencing life and maybe perpetuating some of the stereotypes that we still see today?
It's very unfortunate that the effects of the past are just still very present, in the sense that, yeah, we're still labeling women in our minds, not even realizing it.
I think it goes beyond saying that there are not enough, female actors in strong supporting or lead roles. And now oftentimes I see that when they are, it's a reboot of a different movie, but now just having switched the gender roles, which, you know, I think is, I mean, in itself is a good idea, but reusing an old idea, you know, and trying to use that as a way to sell this new idea.
Because there were a number of incredibly talented people who work in the industry who were there just kind of talking about how much more diversity in the area of gender they want to see in Hollywood. And I think the sheer number of people who do want to see more of that is hopefully what is going to push Hollywood in a better direction.
The gap in the film industry to me is, first off, not understandable at all whatsoever.
But looking at the stats, it looks bad. I'll be honest, it doesn't look great. But realistically, I think things are moving in the right direction.
I did not know that only 14% of women are producers in Hollywood. I believe that. I don't really know why this is an issue, if it's because more women aren't trying to become directors or producers, and there's that balance between all these guys that are trying to do it and these little amount of women, and that's the difference in, or if, you know, it's split 50-50 of men versus women in Hollywood.
To be honest, I'm surprised that they're that high. They were low, and I just... It's still not good, but... it doesn't seem like they're even that high.
The fact that only, like, 34% of all speaking characters are women is kind of really annoying, because women are everywhere, and... I'm in a film production class right now at the college, and I'm the only girl in it. And every time I say anything, I always feel like people are taking everything I say with a grain of salt, or they're not fully listening to me. We watched a clip of Grease, and a lot of people, when I said that I liked the movie, they were like, oh, of course you like Grease, you're a girl. And I'm like, that has nothing to do with why I like Grease.
Like, there should never be a case for anybody to base anything off of your guy or your girl. Like, that should just never be, it should have never been a thing that we've ever had to deal with in history. It shouldn't have been, but it always has been. And we're at this turning point now where we do have this opportunity for everybody to actually move on to being an equal player in everything. It's also dumb. It's all so small-minded, and I don't think it should matter to anybody. I don't think whether you're a male or a female should be even remotely relevant. Take into account what the person is capable of, their work history, their resume, their portfolio, and offer a person a job based on that.
It's safer to go with history, with what's historically worked for Hollywood. And what's historically worked for Hollywood that has made them money is male directors. That's why you see lack of representation in all minorities. Because they're sticking to what's safe, to what's worked before. The problem is that doesn't leave room open to try new things. It doesn't leave room open to progress naturally, like society has progressed. A lot of these films, they may put forward progressive ideas, but the problem is that they're being created by an industry that is actually not progressive in the way that they hire at all. It's very clear, right? I just want to see more perspectives. I want to see people who have stories to tell their stories and tell it well. And I want to see the industry move away from the profit motive. I get it, we want to make millions of dollars, but what does money matter? I think that's a huge part of it.
If you were to ask anyone, I'm sure anyone who was truly honest with themselves would say that's really not how the way it should be, considering that people in general are just starting to step out of the boundaries of what society has had in mind of them for them before.
That irritates me personally, because that is exactly what I want to do. So the fact that it's only 16% gives me a lot of anxiety, because
someone who wants to be a dancer and a musical theater performance artist, I have been told maybe you should take a business class. Yeah.
One thing I will say is the fact that only 34% of women are speaking characters, that's just, I didn't know that. To be perfectly honest with you, it's not something I had ever noticed or considered. You watch a film or a movie that's got a strong female protagonist and you think, she kind of rules, that's a sick character. But then you see the stats and you're like, oh, that's why I noticed that thing, that thing I noticed was way more noticeable, because it's really, really uncommon.
Even if you ask someone randomly off the street, hey there, name 8 famous directors, it's very doubtful that they're going to be able to name any female directors. In general, they never reach the heights of your Spielbergs or your Kubricks or whoever, so it's a lot harder for people to really pick up on them as well.
Is it really 4%?
It's appalling to be hearing that in 2015.
This beautiful creative industry has almost the worst report card of all industries.
Stop saying that there's not enough qualified women. They're out there.
Women are more than half of the world.
We have a real way of seeing the world that is not necessarily separate from men, but we have a point of view.
Isn't it going to be a richer, better experience in the movies if we get to hear from other people?
Storytellers. I don't think that it's necessarily those people's fault for not putting enough women in their things. I don't think necessarily we should sit down and be like, okay, let's make sure that we have 50% men and 50% women. It'd be an odd way to write a story. I think that it's so important to hire female storytellers because they have perspectives that I don't have. They have stories to tell that I don't have. Everybody does. This goes for all people. The more people that are telling stories, the more varied perspectives that we get, the better an understanding of other people we get. Let me kind of rephrase that because it was a weird way to say it. The more perspectives that we can start to understand, the more people we can begin to understand. And film is a way that we do that in the world. Film is a way to understand other people. So
I think it's really sad that it was only 4% that were directors and writers during, I think it said like 2015, 14, something like that. That's really sad to hear, and being a writer myself, I think that it's really sad that there's not a lot of, that it's only gone up like 12% in that many years.
I agree with Michael Moore when he said that wouldn't film in general just be richer if we had different perspectives? Like, and recently in 2018, it's been proven that like films directed by women and films directed by minorities are just as, if not more, profitable than most.
Is when there are films out there that sort of celebrate the number of women that are working on them, they oftentimes receive a ton of backlash. Like,
why shouldn't there be more? There should be. There should be all sorts of different viewpoints and perspectives and stories from all different kinds of people.
What movie do you want to see?
I don't know, I'd kind of really be...
Oh, look at this, it's a movie written and directed by a man.
Cool.
Let's go see it.
Okay, awesome.
Oh, come on, how many movies are written and directed by men these days?
Let's go see a male-driven comedy. I'm so glad you guys are finally meeting Claudia. Chris is an amazing male director.
You don't have to say male. I'm just a director.
If a comedy sketch clip is so funny in how it perfectly highlights the weird way women in creative fields tend to be treated, especially male-dominated creative fields such as directing, cinematography, screenwriting, editing, anything of that sort. Because so often a female director is treated kind of with kids' gloves, for lack of a better word. It's always the best female director or the best director among women. You very rarely get people commenting how good a female director is just as a director. There always has to be a caveat of, oh, but for a woman, when that's really not fair. You wouldn't do the same thing for a male director as
I signaled out in conversations for being a male director and were denied because a woman, a director who was a woman, had more experience in little things like that, which can definitely get in the way of a lot of opportunities.
If you're a good photographer, if you're a good writer, you know, you photograph, you write. That's part of who you are. You know, that's something that you became good at. You know, I don't know too many people that are good at being male or female. It's just something that you kind of get, you know, it's just sort of an incidental thing. If men were treated the same way women are in Hollywood in trying to write and direct films, and it really is just an incredible injustice. And And I think it's something that that definitely needs to be talked about a little bit more, or a lot more, so that we can get to that point where it becomes sort of a non-issue.
It's a perspective that most people don't consider, and it's so true. You hear those things said about females all the time, not necessarily even in the movie industry, where it's just, there's just not enough female talent. No, it's just like really neglected.
I'll talk about Moonrise Kingdom. It's one of my favorite Wes Anderson films. So in this film, there's a boy and a girl, and they both have their problems or whatever. They both feel alienated and kind of othered by the communities around them. And basically, they run away together because they're in love. Keep in mind, these kids are probably like somewhere between like 10 and 14. They're incredibly young. She's portrayed as a character who feels like she lacks control in her life. She feels like she's not understood by people, and she's not cared for. And so she takes action as having agency, separate from both her parents and from this boy, but at the same time tied to both her parents and this boy. It's a very, in my opinion, in a very Wes Anderson-y kind of way, a very realistic take on personhood.
The first movie that came to mind is Hermione from all the Harry Potters. For starters, she's portrayed as an independent person, as in she's not reliant on a male. If anything, like, Ron is reliant on her.
Malfoy, you're okay? Let's go! Come, quick! Let's go!
Run for the world to anyone, understood?
That felt good.
Not good. Brilliant.
She's portrayed as smart and as strong. A characteristic to see, like you see regarding women often. It's usually the lesser, needier character. So that's a huge contrast. And she has her own backstory. She's a very developed character. Whereas with a lot of other female characters in movies, they're not. Because they don't play as much of a role, so they don't need to be as developed. Whereas she was.
Women like that. See, it's interesting that for you, what you said for name a movie you like that has a strong female role and how is it portrayed, I think it's interesting that you even have one of those, because off the top of my head, I hate that I don't have one.
I think in general, audience members tend to identify with characters that they see more of themselves in, and one of the biggest way to do that is gender. So when it comes to female role models, there are so many interesting and dynamic women to go through. Well-done characters such as Sarah Connor or Ellen Ripley. These characters are usually a much more masculine kind of woman. So Peggy Carter always interested me as just how feminine she is. She is a feminine character, and yes, this is obviously to make her appealing to the presumed male audience, but she's never necessarily sexualized, nor is her femininity seen as a weakness. She is competent, strong, clever, and works incredibly hard in an incredibly male-dominated field, i.e. the US Army in this alternate history 1940s.
Step forward, Hodge. Put your right foot forward.
Can you get a rasa? Because I got a few moves I know you'll like.
I really like seeing a character like that, because I think even now when we're working our way towards more female action roles, they do still tend to fall into a more masculine end of femininity. So it's nice to see a female action character who is allowed to be feminine and girly, for lack of a better word, but is never necessarily put down for that.
A film that I saw really, really recently, namely Bad Times at the El Royale. And the character I want to talk about is Darlene.
I figured I would get some rest at the El Royale.
And my favorite moment for her was sort of later down the line, where she is sort of talking to the film's antagonist, who is this sort of very, very misogynistic, but surface level charismatic cult leader guy, who takes advantage of a lot of women and is just a very, very creepy character in general. And he's trying to do his whole shtick, and she just like shuts him up and tells him that she's not scared of him and his kind. She's just tired and doesn't want to deal with him anymore, and the fact that he masks the fact that he is in fact very small behind big words and big empty talk. And it's coming from, the character works in the entertainment industry, so, and it is established early on that she is used to dealing with men like that, and like sort of in the same vein as that, with Hollywood in the state that it is right now, with the Me Too movement and a lot of terrible people and abusers getting called out for doing their terrible, terrible things. It was just a really impactful speech that she gives.
And in most horror films, the females are the protagonist. In fact, one of the first horror films that I ever saw as a kid was A Nightmare on Elm Street. And if you look, nearly every single female character in a Freddy Krueger movie is a strong woman.
You think you was gonna get away from me?
I know you too well now, Freddy.
No. You die.
It's too late, Krueger.
Independent in one way or another, they're either being, you know, strong and independent about their sexuality, or about their abstinence from sex, or whatever. You know, like they are strong characters, and at least one of them always triumphs over Freddy in the end.
Is there certain things that you do with female characters that you don't do with male characters? So an example I often think about is the first Michael Bay Transformers movie. Now that movie is wildly misogynistic, even by major action movie standards. But one of the most interesting things in the movie is a very well-known shot of Megan Fox working on Shia LaBeouf's character's car, where she is leaned down over the car and she's speaking pretty eloquently about things about the car, but the camera is so incredibly focused on showing off her body as an object and as a thing to be desired. And even the character in the scene, Sam, played by Shia LaBeouf, who the audience is supposed to identify with, sees her as an object. He's not at all listening to the mechanical knowledge she has. He's looking at her boobs and going, wow, she's really hot. If that scene was shot with a man, everyone would be wildly confused, because that never happens with male characters. When you look at superhero movie, the way that Captain America fights compared to the way Black Widow fights is pretty different, and that's not just because one of them's a spy and one of them's a soldier. And you can tell they're different even if you can't exactly identify why. Little things like that are, if switched, would wildly change an audience's perception, especially when it comes to male characters, because male characters, in general, are not sexualized on film to the same degree women ever are. You never get a Megan Fox oogling over the car scene in Transformers with a guy. As stated before, you get lots of scenes of sexy dudes, but they're not meant to be objects, they're meant to be audience surrogates.
TV shows like Friends, that have a balance of male and female roles, I think are fantastic. If you were to take Friends, for example, and switch any one of the females with any one of the males, like switch, say, Jennifer Aniston's character with David Schwimmer's character.
Who's Michael?
Oh my God. Oh my God, Ross, no, hang up the phone. Give me the phone, Ross.
I think it would be an interesting dynamic in that particular show. It would, it might actually be a lot more funny in kind of a silly way. I don't know.
Just look at an older movie and say like, well, what would it be like if the roles were reversed? Like say for instance, Titanic. What if it was Jack who was, you know, about to throw himself off the back of the ship, and Rose came, you know, even with all of the bullshit and the pressure that she was under, you know, from her, you know, her well-to-do mom and her, you know, abusive boyfriend, you know, put all that aside for a second and think about somebody else. You know, but they immediately make her the victim. You know, and Jack is just this sort of guy who's got nothing to lose, but hey, I think I'll save her because I'm bored. You know, what if they were to switch that around and make her the hero? You know, but then that would mean that she would have to be the one to die at the end. And again, this is one of those things where it's like, you're like, oh, well, we can't kill a woman in a movie, you know, unless she's really bad. Be still treated with kid's gloves. You know, is this precious little thing that can't be harmed, and like, it might, you know, disturb or distort our tender sensibilities.
Is because there is a bias. There is this misconception that women can't win awards, and if they're nominated for awards, then that's people's minds are blown, and that's wrong. It should be no different than if Peter Jackson gets nominated for an award, you know? We're all humans.
What we can do as a society and as creators is basically just to talk about it, honestly. Like a lot of things get swept under the rug, like it's no big deal. Like we all feel the effects in some way. It's just, with time passing by, I just feel that we tend to like retreat inward rather than seeking like a true community, true connection.
I think change would need to come from the audience, to be honest. The audience would need to want more female directors, or we need to push for a change.
I think to fix the problem, we need to highlight the problem. But I think there's a right way and a wrong way to do that. I think drawing attention to the fact that there's such a disparity, that's a good thing. But I think when female creators draw attention to themselves based solely on their gender, that pushes the argument back in a negative way. I think we are moving in the right direction, but we're not getting there nearly quickly enough.
Every viewpoint of a story can be presented in one way or another, whether that is in directing or writing. To just encourage them, saying that it is improving, and maybe not as quickly as most would like, but it has gone up 12% since it was at 4%. As of 2017, and I think that is a good motivator to inspire more people to write and direct.
And so I think it's just a matter of people in the industry being aware of their own biases and opening their minds to new, unique ideas. It shouldn't be unique, but it is. I definitely think that we as a society, if we want more female filmmakers, then we have to go see the movies that are made by female filmmakers. The social movement's not going to be the only thing to fix this. It'll definitely play a part, but it's not going to be the main reason that the industry will listen. The film industry, as much as we would like it to be run by creativity and love of story, it's not. It's run by money, because the film industry is one of the biggest industries right now. It's just how it is, and if we want more of something, we have to support what we like. Really, the audience, if it's big enough, holds the power. So, as a society, to fix it, we need to show Hollywood that this is what we want, that we do hold the power.
A little bit of kindness in the world goes a long, long way. Show love, get love. Show hate, get hate. It's just, that's how people operate at a root level.
Some of the most creative people that I know are women. I mean, why aren't more women directing? There's no sense to it. They're just as good at seeing something and making it happen as men are. There can be no argument made, in my opinion, that makes any sense whatsoever. And it's odd because we're seeing other industries now kind of like jumping way ahead of this very, very creative industry, where they're getting a little bit more gender parity, or they're working on gender parity. Because it is hard. It is hard to break into an industry that marginalizes you. It's scary, and not everybody wants to do it.
Hollywood's perception of on reality doesn't it no.
It's ridiculous.
It's overhyped. It's the, like, men are supposed to be held to this, like, stupid standard of image. Women are supposed to be held to even more so. And, like, you get, like, this much of what women actually are when really you have, like, this much of the world.
Incredibly male-dominated. And I think that is really unfortunate because that is a significant amount of the population that you just aren't hearing from as much in the film industry. And, like, I would really love to hear more female voices.
So if you want to be a director, if you want to be a producer, if you want to be an actress, then pursue it. We should encourage women to follow their pursuits, whether that be the entertainment industry or the STEM industry or art or teaching or science or programming. It
shouldn't matter race, gender, creed, sexual orientation, anything like that should not matter.
Maybe we should just stop making it such a thing, you know, like treating it like, oh, she's so brave for having written a screenplay, you know, oh, she's so courageous to be directing this action film. It's crazy.
I don't think that is, I mean, sure, like, there may be some instances where, yeah, we're gonna hire a female director for this because we want to, like, we want to have this political stance on it, or we want to make this statement about it. Sure, fine, whatever. But I don't see the, like, I would almost prefer it if they didn't even tell you who the director was until, like, 6 months after the film was done. I think that would change everything. Like, the simple fact that women used to write books and take on a pen name of a guy just so they could sell their book. To me, that's absurd. Why does that matter? Why does that matter?
Why does it, you know, I know plenty of women who are talented writers, who are just amazing photographers, and getting stamped female photographer, female writer. They're just writers, just photographers.
As for our opinions and our thoughts, you know, I'm talking to a camera and I'm gonna send that to you over the internet, and you're gonna take the thoughts of different creators and you're gonna talk to a camera and you're gonna edit that, put that all together. You're gonna create something and you're gonna upload it to a platform where millions of people can see it. And it doesn't matter if you're female or male, or what color you are, or what religion you are. The gatekeepers are gone, and the ability for people to create and put things out there for other people to see is just incredible. So instead of dwelling on a number, or how things used to be, or how things are, think about how things can be.